Logging into a managed Chromebook will bring you to this screen. And when you log in at this screen, it will log you into both the Chromebook and web desk at the same time. So after entering your credentials here, or after scanning the QR code, the user will be logged into the Chromebook, logged into web desk, and it will look like this. The first thing I'd like to talk to you about is the shelf. It's this row down here at the bottom. On a PC, it's often called a taskbar or something of that nature. Chromebooks call it the shelf. One thing that you'll see in this corner is a white circle. That is called the Apps Launcher. There is a separate video that will take you through how to use the Apps Launcher. That is where you can download apps, and you download them through the Apps Launcher. It's where you can find them, and that's where you access them. Going on down the line is the shelf. These are some of the apps that I have pinned to my shelf because I access them very frequently. So the one app that I downloaded was YouTube and Google Drive and the Dell Activity Light. This is ClassLink, WebDesk, and that's Nearpod. So if you have an app that you frequently access, you can pin it down to your shelf, and you just touch the little button at the bottom. You click on this little icon down here and it'll launch it for you. Moving on down the line over here, you'll see the time. If you need to check on the battery life, that's where you do that too. The battery life is pretty great. If I charge it up overnight and use it on and off throughout the day, it will last. And it'll also give you a percentage and a time. So if you only have 10 minutes left on your battery, you can actually see how many hours and minutes are left of battery life in your Chromebook. If you tap on your profile picture, which is in this bottom corner, this menu will pop up. You'll have more options in here, such as changing the Wi-Fi. So if you need to switch to your home Wi-Fi, if you take your teacher Chromebook home, that's how you could do that. There's some volume control, and there's a settings gear. It doesn't say settings, it looks like a little gear. And if you tap on that, in the settings, you can do things like activate the international keyboard, change accessibility settings, adjust the time, connect Bluetooth. There are lots of different settings in this area. I'm gonna close that out. One other thing about this particular model of Chromebook, you're gonna notice that there's no left or right click buttons on the touchpad. That's not actually a thing on Chromebooks. If you want to left click, you take one finger and you go to the touchpad and you press whatever it is you want to open one time. That was a left click. If I want to right click on something, I put the mouse on wherever I need to go, use two fingers, and tap both fingers anywhere on the touchpad. That's a right click. Another thing you can do is press and hold, similar to our phones. If I want to right click on that little icon right down there, if I take my finger, touch the screen, press and hold, that also gave me the right click menu. If you are interested in checking your email, it's in here, Office 365, and there's another whole video that walks you through that entire process. There's your Pinnacle Gradebook. You will find that lots of apps you're used to using will be here automatically installed for you. And there's a plus sign right up here to find more. And we have another video that we'll link you to that will walk you through how to find other apps to use on your Chromebook. One last thing I'll show you that is specific to these Chromebooks is when you log in. I'm logged into this Chromebook right now, If I sign out, if I push that little button, the sign out button is right up here. If I sign out and go to a completely different Chromebook and sign in, it will look exactly the same. All of my bookmarks, settings, pinned apps, anything that I do follows me, the user. It does not save it to the actual Chromebook itself. So keep that in mind if you are going to have somebody else sign in on a Chromebook or you are going to use a Chromebook. Just remember that it follows your login, not the device. Thanks for watching.